They are the mugshots of the son and dad just arrested in connection with the cold case of missing college student Kristin Smart. And now police are giving special thanks to this man, Chris Lambert, whose podcast is credited with cracking the baffling 25-year-old case wide open.
What Chris did with his podcast was he took a local story that was generally locally and he expanded it to a national story. In international.
I spoke to Lambert today.
This is every article that's ever been printed about Kristin Smart in any newspaper, sorted by year. A forensics tent was set up on his front lawn.
Chris launched his podcast, Your Own Backyard, 2 years ago.
What was it about this case that made you cling on to it?
I was 8 years old when Kristin went missing, and it was a name that would come up in the news every so often. And once I was an adult and could go on the internet and read about it myself, I started realizing, wow, there's a lot of information here that the general public is never discussing.
Kristin was last seen walking back to her dorm after a fraternity party at Cal Poly University in California. Another student, Paul Flores, was with her but told police they parted ways. Yesterday, Flores was arrested and charged with murdering Kristin after authorities say he tried to rape her in his dorm room. His 80-year-old father, Ruben Flores, also was charged with being an accessory.
Can you tell us what sort of new evidence you came up with?
There were a number of new witnesses that came forward to me that they had either never spoken to or who had left out pieces of information or had been overlooked for whatever reason.
Lambert says he's discovered that 44-year-old Paul Flores has lived a very troubled existence.
My understanding is that his behavior has continued around women. He's continued to drink heavily. He's had several DUI charges.
The local DA today said there may be more victims.
We do have evidence in this case that leads us to conclude that there very well may be additional victims in the Southern California area. He was known to frequent bars.
The nature of Ruben Flores' alleged role as an accessory is yet to be revealed. But the podcaster captured footage of detectives digging outside his home, taking soil samples.
I think it's very likely that Kristin's body was at one or both of his parents' houses at different points.
He says despite the arrests, Kristin Smart's family still does not have closure.
They're relieved, but it's surreal, and it's kind of bittersweet for them because their daughter still hasn't been found.